Well, good evening, everyone. Michael Soothing here. I hope I don't get demonetized for saying my channel name or my YouTube name, because the topic of this video is the current censor something policies of the forum and medium in which I am speaking to you. So I promise I still plan to put you to sleep, even though I'm talking about this almost contra something versus something topic. You see, there are bots that are scanning every word I say, looking for every reason to demonetize my videos. Not as if I am trying to make money on this venture. That's not why I make them. When you're getting 10 cents an hour for your endeavors, and you spend a lot more than that on your equipment, it's not really a money-making exercise, but nonetheless, it's kind of nice to have a little something by way of remuneration coming back for the time that it takes, although I would make them anyway. Whether there was advertising, when I made the Jodi Araya videos under a previous life, and it was a completely different life then, by the way, a few years back, I never tried to monetize any of my videos. You know, but eventually on this channel I did. So what's the deal now? What constitutes what can and cannot be said in the current environment? Well, let me put it this way. You could do anything beyond Disney Channel. No, I take that back. You wouldn't even be able to do Disney Channel content anymore on this forum without getting demonetized. I would say anything beyond Sesame Street or perhaps Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. In other words, anything you might say that could ever come across as an explicit term of some kind or as offensive to someone somewhere, even if that person might be on Mars, even if that person might be, say, a chipmunk who doesn't like the way you referred to chipmunks, those would be subjected to the type of censorship that would involve demonetization. Now, you know, I have never on my channel resorted to excessive profanity something or, you know, explicit something terminology. But I thought maybe if we had a legitimate use for some of that kind of language in a video, say a doctor role play again, for example, maybe we should use some substitute terms. And then I wouldn't have to be demonetized. For example, if I wanted to say a pair of something, like, say, some male junk, for example, we could say, get a pair, right? I could say, crystals, you know, get a pair of crystals, maybe. Or if we were referring to some of the more feminine type assets, we could say, conversely, a pair of spheres or something. you know, something along those lines. I need visual aids because otherwise I can't remember the things I wanted to, you know, ever since I remarried. I'm learning a few new terms, for example, a certain anatomical part my spouse refers to as a flower, okay? Doesn't look like this, but I wouldn't want any graphic details in my video, you know, to make it appear as if it had to be censored in some way. And of course, that would apply to other things too, so if you hear me say something like banana in the future, you know, maybe you would know what I was referring to, or flower. The reason I call it a banana is because of the movie Sling Blade, and those of you who remember the film will know why I say, because there's a line where Billy Bob Thornton, the very brilliant writer, actor, and director of that film, is talking about what a sling blade is. And he says, it's a curved blade shaped kind of like a banana. Anyway, if I talk about a sock, you know, maybe you can figure out what it might be protecting. Not my feet, I don't know. Not that I'm at that stage in life anymore. You know, if I'm gonna tackle a subject this difficult, I need to do some gum chewing. And so, I have it on good authority by my new spouse, Scorpio Ann, that this double bubble gum actually tastes like birthday cake. So I want to test it and see while we're chatting on this topic. These, of course, are the spherical kind. What we would call, as you can see here on the label, gum spheres, okay? That's what I'm going to call them so that I don't run afoul of anybody's censorship rules. So we will get ourselves a pair of gum spheres. I wonder if chewing is offensive. Probably. All right. So, I promised you that I would try to put you to sleep by boring you to death just a little bit. You can no longer use terms like that. You can't put that in your title. You can't talk about politics or religion, really, or anything involving human interaction, unless it's the most benign variety. I wonder if even Mr. Rogers would pass muster. Anyway, I'm going to read you the new guidelines, and they sound kind of reasonable, but the way they're being interpreted, it's not so reasonable. I mean, you can't, of course, say the B word or the F word. I saying that fast so the audio screening bot won't flag me. You can't say the S word like sword, right? You can't use a term in your title or anywhere that would indicate more than one type of gender preference. And so, rather than saying be I something or other, you would have to say maybe something, maybe we could come up with code language like multi-oriented or something like that, I don't know. You know, we could say, well, I'm not going to try to guess at all the terms. Instead, I wonder if I'll be able to blow a bubble with this gum. I think it's going to take a pair in order to pull that off. I'm trying to be so careful with what I say. You're not allowed right now anymore to have a sense of humor, but I promise to get around that somehow, because I cannot think or speak without a sense of humor. I would have to be mute, deaf, and dumb. Of course, I can pull off the dumb part okay, but not the other parts. By the way, this does indeed taste like birthday cake. Before I bore you with the new guidelines, they're not new, they've been in effect for a few months now. Some of my most benign videos got demonetized. You wouldn't believe it. I think I had one where I was cooking something, you know. My title was too inflammatory or something. You know, like red hot chicken or something, you know, who knows? Anyway, where were we? Blowing a bubble. If I did a job on my gum, well, scratch that thought. Anyway, I printed out the article that explains the guidelines. I don't want to read all of it, even though it would achieve the ASMR goal of putting you to sleep immediately. But I'll read a little bit of it, skipping the first couple pages. YouTube is trying to walk a careful line with these new guidelines. The company needs to give brands more assurance that their ads won't be placed before objectionable content. In other words, anything that isn't, you know, a green frog making a croak sound, while also minimizing, what was the green frog's name? I can never remember names. Kermit, that's it. Now you guys don't have to tell me in comments. Usually you have to tell me names in comments, which I appreciate, of course. I don't appreciate every comment. Like, some Nimrod was saying to me a day or two ago. Oh, you don't make legitimate ASMR, whatever legitimate means in this case, because you're not doing role play and meditation videos. Well, of course, I have done role play and I've done relaxation videos many times. And then he went on to object that I'm talking about my life, you know, your spouse and your girlfriend, whatever. I mean, she was my girlfriend, you know, then spouse. My previous wife passed away. Anyway, you're talking about the stuff in your house and blah, blah, blah. To which I say, maybe I'll make a video about what constitutes legitimate ASMR. Maybe I'll make a video like that quite soon. The summary answer is, whatever relaxes someone is legitimate ASMR. That would be the short answer. And, of course, in my own personal opinion, doing something you enjoy that's relaxing and authentic is more legitimate as ASMR than doing a bunch of phony contrived stuff, you know, or, you know, brushing things on the microphone. You know, I just can't get into all of that, right? But anyway, I got so far off track, which, as someone who commented, whose a comment I did appreciate, said, it wouldn't be a Michael Soothing video if it didn't go off topic and off track. Very true. Good insight. Anyway, where were we? The company will give brands more assurance. Their ads won't be placed before objectionable content, while also minimizing negative reaction from popular creators who depend on ad revenue. I'm glad I don't depend on ad revenue, or I would be starving. Which isn't such a bad thing anyway. It's a necessary dance. Are you allowed to say dance? Well, YouTube, you're not allowed to say dance in your title if there are certain descriptors in front of the dance, the term dance. They would demonetize you. Like, you couldn't say, for example, you couldn't say that kind of dance. You couldn't say that kind of dance. Well, we could go on and on. I know you think I'm making this up, but I'm not, I can assure you. It's a necessary dance as YouTube tries to balance the freewheeling nature of creativity with the ad money flowing through its business. You know, there's far more controversy associated with the current hoopla over NFL football, and I don't see anyone there saying we're going to, demonetize the major networks and refuse to run ads on them if anyone does anything controversial or offensive. Anyway, the new guidelines, according to YouTube VP of Product Management, Ariel Bardin, take a tougher stance on hateful content. Again, that means if a chipmunk on Mars could potentially be offended by you talking about him storing an acorn for the winter, if you use the wrong term, like storing a nut for the winter, that would be hate speech. Okay. Content that promotes discrimination or disparages or humiliates an individual or group of people on the basis of their race, ethnicity, ethnic origin, nationality, religion, disability, age, veteran status, something or other orientation. If I even read their own guidelines, they would demonetize me if I put that in my title, that word. Gender identity or other characteristic associated with systematic marginalization. Okay. It sounds relatively reasonable when you read the paragraph, but if you could see the way it's applied, where any word in your title or in your content can automatically demonetize you because of the little software-driven bots that run around peeking into every nook and cranny of the video, then you would know what I'm talking about. What else is banned? Inappropriate use of family entertainment characters. In other words, you can't make fun of anyone on TV in any way, okay? Even though they're fictional characters, you know. Content that depicts family entertainment characters engaged in violent something or other, you all, vile or otherwise inappropriate behavior, even if done for comedic or satirical purposes. In other words, none of my Jodi Araya videos could ever have survived. And by the way, I will make a follow-up sometime soon, I promise. You know, like a postscript video on my old channel. And when I do, I will give you guys a link, okay? What else? Incendiary and demeaning content. You know, the way they do these terms, see, we'll underline the word and. It says incendiary and demeaning content. I think they should have used or there instead, don't you? Because this would imply that you could have incendiary content or demeaning content, but not both, because they say incendiary and demeaning content is not allowable, both, but maybe one or the other. Anyway, I'm nitpicking them because, you know why. Content that is incendiary, inflammatory, or demeaning. For example, content that uses gratuitously disrespectful language that shames or insults any individual or group. By this criteria, everything on regular broadcast network TV would have to be banned from advertising, wouldn't it? Because someone somewhere feels demeaned or insulted by virtually every news broadcast, every show, every character on every show, every action taking place on every athletic event, etc., etc. Do you see where I'm going with this? Why is it, as a society, we can't just be ourselves and interact with each other? Can't we teach people to be civil and still have free speech both? How difficult is that? We're getting to the point where we're getting dumbed down and restricted, such that in the end, all we're going to be allowed to talk about is a lump of dough, and that's it, okay? That gives me an idea. I think I'll get some Play-Doh and recreate the old Mr. Bill show. Oh wait, that show was all about being mean to Mr. Bill. And that would be demeaning to him, and he is a character in a show. So that violates number 2. So we can't do that one. Never mind. All right, what else? YouTube plans to crack down on videos that feature recognizable family entertainment characters in unseemly situations. Family entertainment characters. Have they ever watched the show Family Guy, or even cartoon shows like Ren and Stimpy on Nickelodeon? They do understand that demeaning their characters is a standard part of every comedy show or cartoon ever run on TV, or I guess that's a little too tough a concept for the folks coming up with these guidelines, right? That third area, incendiary and demeaning content, might be the hardest, it says here, for YouTube to incontestably define for creators and brands. There's plenty of room for debate. No, there isn't. They're just automatically demonetizing everything. So there is no room for debate, okay? If anyone could find anything controversial in any way, then you can kiss it goodbye if you are trying to have a monetized video. All right, anyway. YouTube says it's working to improve the appeals process for creators who object to having a video marked not advertiser friendly. Have any of these folks, like I said, at YouTube ever watched a single show on TV and applied their own guidelines to it? Aren't those pretty much advertisements I keep seeing every 5 to 8 minutes that are interrupting every show on my television set? I don't watch many shows, but when I do try to watch one, like the very excellent new show about the autistic doctor, the Good Doctor it's called, I should do a video on that topic. Maybe I could do an autistic doctor role play. We know quite a bit about it, about the subject here. Anyway, do these YouTube censors ever bother to see what kind of content is on the biggest distribution networks that exists today, which is, of course, broadcast television? Do they ever watch MSNBC or Fox show of any kind. How about The Simpsons? It would be banned and demonetized on YouTube, as would Family Guy, and just about any cartoon series. You know, Road Runner would be demonetized because it makes fun of the coyote, okay? Anyway, someone would object somewhere. I can't blow a bubble with this gum. I can tell. It's too solid. There's no softness to it. But it does taste a little like birthday cake, I must say. Birthday cake. Oh no, there's a religion who believes you're not supposed to celebrate birthdays. So now I have something offensive in my video. That's not good. I'm sure I'll be demonetized. By the way, notice that the word demon appears in the term demonetized, right? So, I think next time I'm gonna try the Trident Swedish fish. Is this bubble gum? No. But it will spare me the embarrassment of trying to blow a bubble. Can you say itch on the current, under the current guideline? Or is that going to offend someone who has, you know, some kind of skin disease? Do you know how hard it is to sit around and double think everything you're going to say when you're just trying to be natural and be yourself? I just want to do relaxing, authentic, be myself kind of videos. It's too bad that now we have to analyze everything under a microscope and bright lights to see if someone somewhere might be offended. In other words, someone always will, no matter what you say or do, no matter how, you know, innocuous or pablumistic it might be, no matter how benign, no matter if it's nothing in your food other than water and some certain kind of bread, which I can't even say, because then I'll be accused of some kind of discriminatory thought process by the thought police, okay? And you know who the thought police are, those of you who are giving it some thought. The thought police, generally speaking, are those folks who are incapable of actual thought. That's why they become thought police, okay? Anyway, still can't blow a bubble. It's not gonna happen. It's gonna be a fail 67 times over. All right, everyone, I hope this video didn't offend anyone, because heaven forbid that should ever happen. And, you know, don't ASMR and drive until the next time we convene. Take care, everyone. just the seafood we ate tonight. That's it. Okay. Take care. Did I just disparage seafood?